What is going on, guys? Today I am building an L-shaped desk that has a farmhouse vibe to it, but also a modern sleek style. For the tabletop, I took a full sheet of maple plywood, marked the lines that I wanted to cut, and went at it with my circular saw. The longest side will be 60 inches, while the other side will be about 48. To hide the layers of plywood, I cut down some pine strips that'll act as edge banding. There's actually a product made specifically for this, but I don't have any in the shop, so these strips will do. Instead of measuring all of the places that the strips would go and then cut them at the miter saw, I just tagged them in with the nail gun and then cut them right in place. I figured that would eliminate any room for error on my part. Okay, so yesterday I cut out the tabletop and gave it a bunch of trim. It was probably the easiest part of the job. Today I'm gonna work on all the base pieces, which consists of two Farmhouse X style bases and one cabinet that has a door and a drawer. For the elements of the chunky farmhouse legs, I'm cutting down this 4x4 into six different pieces. Two horizontal pieces that will make up the height of the table and four pieces that will mount horizontally and will act as feet and support for the tabletop. To achieve that signature farmhouse look, the feet will have a 45 degree taper. And to make sure all the cuts are identical, I set up a sacrificial block to cut right up against. After everything was cut and I got the look that I wanted, I laid out all of my lines so that I could center up the vertical pieces and cinch them down with screws. I pre-drilled holes about halfway through the 4x4s to hide the screw heads and to get a good hold onto the other 4x4s that I'd be joining them to. Next on the list to cut was the pieces that actually make up the X look. I don't exactly know what these pieces are called, but you cut angles in them, you set them where they belong, and then it makes a big X in your furniture piece. Somebody out there knows what they're called, but I do not. Anyways, moving on. Obviously, if you want your pieces to be perfect, you gotta hide the screws, baby. In my case, I used putty, but you can always use dowels or whatever, caps, anything like that, to plug the hole. I made both of the X legs identical at first, but I decided halfway through that it would look a lot better if the leg that was in the back corner of the desk was a 90 degree leg that followed the shape of the desk. So I just chopped it up a little bit and I'm gonna screw it in place. This is the moment that I realized this is supposed to go 90 degrees this way, and this is supposed to go 90 degrees this way. Maybe you have known the whole time, and you've been watching, and you've saw it, and it looks kind of funny to you, but I didn't know. I can't catch a break. This issue was really not that big of a deal, but it just requires time to fix, and that's what's annoying. The last piece that'll make up this desk is a small little cabinet with a door and a drawer. And about 6 months ago, I started working at a cabinet shop. So, if I screw this up, I'm probably gonna be in pretty big trouble. The same material that I use as edge banding for the tabletop is the material you see me using here for face frame on the cabinet. It's just regular old pine that I will stain to match the rest of the desk. Okay, so now all of the building is done. All four pieces are completed. The top, the 2X bases, and the cabinet. Now we move on to finishing. And by finishing, I mean we're gonna make them dark, baby. For the door and drawer featured in this build, I just cut a piece of plywood to fit the openings and trimmed it out like the rest of the build. If you're interested in how I make drawers, you can reference a video I made called Simple Rustic Nightstands. I didn't include that information here because I'd hate to be overly redundant with the things I show off in my videos. After everything was built, sanded, and stained, all that was left to do was add a clear coat to all four pieces and let it dry. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. If you enjoyed it, please consider subscribing. That would help me out a ton, and I will see you guys in the next video. Peek-a-boo!